The NBC2 investigators expose FEMA fraud is still happening 1 year after Hurricane Irma.
At this exact moment last year, we were on the air showing you some of the first images of the damage from the storm as it pushed north. In the moments that followed, NBC2 investigator Rachel Polansky exposed dozens of cases of fraudulent FEMA registrations. She earned an Edward R. Murrow Award for her series of reports, and Rachel, people are still suffering.
That's right. Just today, the Department of Justice confirmed to me that at least two men, one from Jacksonville and one from Houston, have been charged for submitting false claims for FEMA benefits. In the meantime, thieves continue to steal victims' identities.
Just an upheaval.
When this Cape Coral woman looks back on the last year,
I had no damage. I felt that the first letter was a scam. That phone call came from that tip line. Are they seeking these people? Where do they physically get that information?
She has more questions than answers.
It's just so frustrating.
Victoria Barnisi is one of a dozen people who called the NBC2 investigators last October after they got these letters sent to their homes, telling them that they applied for disaster assistance through FEMA.
We did not have any damage. We were fortunate enough.
The problem was most of them didn't apply for disaster assistance. Someone else did, using their personal information.
We really got worried because it's identity theft is such a scary, scary thing.
A month after our reports aired, a FEMA spokesperson finally agreed to talk with us, confirming that the agency was investigating fraudulent registrations.
In the early days of the investigation, there wasn't a public announcement, in part to protect the integrity of the investigation. NBC2 was the first in this area to make that connection and to see that the large number of fraudulent SBA letters coming in could be a signal that there was something more going on.
Since then, NBC2 has repeatedly asked FEMA for updates on that investigation. And all FEMA will say is that they've, quote, instituted additional identification control measures to ensure that only eligible applicants received assistance, end quote. As far as how many people had fraudulent applications filed in their names, we still don't know.
So very, very wrong that security is not a priority.
And Victoria Barnisi is still battling an identity thief. Even though she's frozen her credit reports, just last month she got this letter from Social Security thanking her for changing her address and setting up a new online account.
That never happened. I've lived at the same place for almost 10 years.
And she can't help but think that it's all connected.
Do you think that all of this goes back to that fraudulent registration that was filed in your name after Hurricane Irma?
I think so. You know, I really do, because my information was out there and someone has it.
According to FEMA's after action report, last year's big storms, Irma, Harvey, and Maria, were among the top five costliest hurricanes on record. Irma ranked fifth of all time with a total price tag of $50 billion. For the NBC2 investigators, I'm Rachel Polansky.